I'll tell you more of my story now, if you care to hear it.
Go ahead.
If you remember, my father had fallen ill. I offered to fetch the mage healer from the city, but my father refused. He insisted herbs were the only way to help him. He was gone before the spring. I was devastated. In time, I grew to hate my father's philosophy and dedicated myself to healing through magic. It was a blind rejection of an entire field because I believed it failed my... because I blamed his death. The truth is, I traded one limiting perspective for another. That's a good place to stop for now. Valhalla is a place of constant flux. Adaptability gives us a means to navigate the uncertainty.
Who wouldn't want to buy a slightly more hospitable environment?
We're all impressed by your progress, Jim. We've never seen anyone engage Valhalla quite the way you have.
Zigrun, how fare you and your sisters?
With just the three of us to attend to the Fallen now, we're short-handed. But we've begun recruiting new Shield Maiden.
Well, I happen to know of one lass who'd jump at the chance to join your ranks.
You mean Thrud? Sif and Thor's daughter? Believe me, I know. She sought us out before the call even left our lips.
She fights well, and can be trusted.
A recommendation from you, General. With that, how could we ignore her? Not that she'd let us.
Kratos, I'm glad to see you're back inside. It seems Valhalla has arranged something special for you in the throne room. See you again soon, Kratos.
this.
You remember this, Kratos. The memory is vivid. A familiar scene to any that know your legend. A man at the crossroads of a fateful decision.
Aye, you've spoken of this, brother. The pact you made with Ares, to stave off the barbarian horde.
The day I sold my soul to a god of war. Why show me this?
Well, if I had to guess, probably to make you feel like the piece of shit you are.
Is he necessary?
He's no part of my design. He's either Valhalla's or yours.
At least he hasn't replaced me again. Not yet, anyway. Seems a real charmer.
A memory fragment of your time in Alfheim, then.
Tell me, who was Kratos of Sparta the day you made your pledge to Ares?
I was the youngest captain in the Spartan army. I had gained a reputation for my skills in combat. My command on the battlefield, but also my aggression. I was determined to never lose, and until then, never had. My men were loyal. Fiercely so.
How many Spartans did you command?
Not enough that day.
How many barbarians did you face?
Thousands.
It's worth the price it exacts, brother. Maybe just for this try, but a little assist would be nice. Unusual little corner of Valhalla, isn't it? Shall we see what else we can find in here? Careful. Who knows what's waiting for you in that mist?
Hmm.
I think we're meant to choose one chest or the other. Shall we have a look?
Why help prepare me to take your old position? Why not fulfill it yourself? You seem capable.
To the mortals of these realms, I am an ancient myth, long out of mind. The days I could hope to unify these realms are long past. But they see you as the hero of that. You are known, respected. And from what I have seen, you're the most qualified by far. You need only be ready.
Yeah!
Ready to move to the next space, brother. Should be clear. it's us!
Guess you're not done with me yet, Kratos. I must say, it's genuinely hard to think of anything stupider than pledging your soul to Ares of all people. I mean, any of Zeus's brood are bound to be garbage, present company by no means excluded. But Ares made a real art out of being vicious and depraved. Though, I suppose I can't begrudge you your role model. I see you still use the blades he gave you. Can you really say you regret a decision, and still keep benefiting from the trappings of that decision? I'm not sure I understand, Skip. You ever try to do the math on how many people died as a result of your little collaboration? Contemplating the grains of sand on a beach, isn't it? Just overwhelming, honestly.
What is that?
Like someone left you a party favor. Oh, and it's a symbolic totem of your shame.
That's so thoughtful.
Ah, now you've done it. You're being judged. And we all know your past actions wouldn't pass muster with anybody. Please, take your sweet, sweet time. siren? Cover my ears! Kratos!
Right. Delay, Kratos.
From behind, incoming!
Oh, not the song attack!
The horns, the horns!
I'm back.
Well done, Kratos. I brought something else to keep things interesting. You're not the only one with weapons from far-off lands, you know.
Ready?
Ambitious. Proud. I could not accept defeat. I crave power.
Is that all? Are you sure? Nothing more to that story? Nothing else under the surface? No!
I yield, Kratos.
Very well.
I believe you found an understanding within yourself. Shall we see?
Fools. It's not only memories.
Indeed. For what is a memory apart from our perspective on it? You know the evils that came of your path. You know the evils within yourself. Yes, these you dwell on. But it's not that simple, is it?
The horde is vast, brother. What would have happened if you didn't stop it?
Our lands would have been overrun. Our people killed, violated.
People your army was sworn to protect. An army led by you. Did you not feel a duty to fulfill your purpose? Did you not fear for the safety of your homeland? You saved them.
You would excuse my actions?
Excusing them is not the exercise, Kratos. Only accepting them. Accepting that you acted based on what you knew then, not on what was to come. Your motivation and their consequences are far more complicated than you let yourself believe. I think perhaps you have more to process.
Yes. I have. Much to think about. I will return.
And I will be waiting.